Studies show that approximately every 40 seconds a person dies from suicide.
In honor of World Suicide Prevention Awareness Day, a local woman shares her experience with suicide and how she hopes others can be reached in time. ABC 7's Lamaya Harvell has the story.
Why wouldn't he talk to me? Why wouldn't he have given us an opportunity to talk to him?
Sarah Williamson remembers her son, Aaron, being responsible and compassionate. In March of 2008, Aaron was making plans for his high school graduation.
He left the house and he seemed flustered, worried, really concerned about something. And his last words to me were, "Mom, something bad has happened and I have to take care of it."
Williamson went after Aaron. She drove around the neighborhood trying to find her son.
And at one point, I actually passed him and I thought he was headed home.
Authorities said they had found her son's car in a field. Aaron had taken his own life.
I felt literally like there was a gorilla sitting on my chest and I couldn't breathe.
Family Support Services Director Amy Horde says suicide is increasing, and the best thing we can do is look for the signs.
Are they making statements of hopeless statements, or they can't plan for the future, or they're making statements of the world would be better off, or their family would be better off without them?
Williamson says Aaron showed no signs, but she found a way to keep his memory alive.
We opened a scholarship in his name. It's the Aaron Scott Williamson Memorial Scholarship at Kanakuk Camps. And we're trying to send kids who've been affected in some way by suicide. That's our first priority.
After 11 long years, Mrs. Williamson is still grieving over the death of her son. She says if she could see him just one last time, she knows exactly what she would say.
Just tell me about it. Sit here and talk to me. And pause, and I will walk with you through anything because I love you.
In Amarillo, Lamaya Harvell, ABC 7 News.
Williamson also partners with the local Outreach for Suicide Survivors program. She says the program gives her life meaning because she's able to help support other survivors who are going through the same trauma.
To get more information on any crisis outreach programs or how you can help, you can contact the Texas Panhandle Suicide Prevention Awareness Coalition on Facebook.